Hey guys, welcome back. So yesterday I posted a video where I was emotionally ranting about how disappointed I am in the reveal trailer of Project Cars 3 and how arcadey it looks and how it's more like a arcade game rather than a sim racing. I got a lot of mixed reviews on my video, and I will show you the comments. I got a lot of good comments. I would say all of them were good. All of them came from the both sides of the perspective, from a sim racer's point of view and from an arcade racer's point of view. And many people supported that they liked the idea of Project Cars 3 being a little bit user friendly, as in comparison to Project Cars 2's physics, which were really hard to master for a casual racer. So I would like to show you some of the comments that I find very interesting. Like I said, none of them were bad comments or wrong comments. I mean, I did agree with one or two comments, but otherwise I think all of them were really nice of them. Like this one says here, like, that both Project Cars 1 and 2 felt like early access games, as both were unplayable on gamepad, glitches and weird animation. These were horrible console races, not speaking from a wheel perspective. And then he says that it's funny how I compare Project Cars 3 to GT and Forza, as if both those franchises play the same. FM7 is a borderline arcade, but both are playable on gamepad. PCs don't even try to make it possible on gamepads, making PS4 and Xbox releases pointless, since I assume 95% of owners don't own a wheel. He's correct in his point of view, but there's a reason why I compared this game to Forza and GT Sport. I should not have compared PC3 to GT Sport, because GT Sport is an entry level sim racer. Now, it's not a sim kit, it's a simulator, and it's an entry level simulator, whereas Forza Motorsport is a pure, I would say, sim kit or an arcade racer, a track based arcade racer. So I think it was not right of me to compare PC3 to GT Sport. So here it is, another comment that I really find interesting is, I understand 99% of your sentiment and I slightly agree with it, but how many times I need to say this? We need to free our minds from the idea that there are only realistic racing sims or arcade driving sims. When I started Euro Truck Simulator 2 and asked the community about the simulation aspect, they were like, physics, we don't know. So this is what I'm saying. Project Cars 2 is not for people who don't understand physics and how racing cars work. And, you know, like he says, the problem isn't in road cars or driving on road. The problem is in the core physics engine examples, such as car control, understeer, oversteer, throttle. This is what I was saying, that Project Cars 3 might not have a very hard physics engine, or maybe they tone it down, but I have read somewhere that they are taking the physics from Project Cars 2 and implementing in Project Cars 3. But if they are doing it, then I don't know how the new casual player will be able to cope with that. I'm really skeptical about that, and I'm really curious to see the result of that engine. What else? And this comment over here, that actually there is a gap in good PC sim kits. The only good one is Forza 7. I am happy with their decision. Like I said, many people are agreeing with it. Many people are not, like many like this one. Logically, to me, since Codemaster owned both Grid IP and now SM Studio, it seems idiotic to make a full arcade game. I'm feeling you, bro. This is a crime to the true fans of PC 2. I'm still hoping this is a big prank. A lot of people on this video that I posted yesterday posted comments from both sides, and I would say, like I said, I don't disagree with any of them. There are people who love simcades or arcade racing games, and there are people like me who only like simulator racing and enjoy it a lot. I literally, not joking right now, I built a brand new PC just to play Forza Horizon 4, and to be honest, I downloaded Forza Horizon 4, I played it only for like hour or 2 hours max, and the next thing I was doing, I bought ACC and I'm just playing that game non-stop for days now. So this is the thing. I come from an arcade background. I enjoy arcade gaming a lot. I used to enjoy Need for Speed and all these kind of things, but now I'm more of a sim racer. So if we go to here to this article from PC Gamer, here we can say that the third game in the racing game series promises major changes to both single player and multiplayer. Over here they are saying that Project Car has amazed a large loyal following of virtual motorsport fans thanks in part to impressively realistic car physics, but the series has always been missing a few of the features accepted from a modern racing sim, something its developer plan to remedy. Okay, fine. So here they talk about career mode, how they have made it from the scratch and giving players a better sense of progression with XPs and unlocking upgrade parts and all that typical that you find in an arcade game. To be honest, anyone who is a sim racer, I can say 70% of the time no sim racer usually plays a career mode in any of the games, whether it's GT Sports, ACC, Project Cars 2. I have ACC, I have Project Cars 2, I have Dirt Rally 2.0, I have GT Sports, and all these four games that I own, I have never played career mode more than an hour or two. Just and the only reason I play career mode is just to get a hang of how the game feels, how the physics are, and after that I just jump into directly multiplayer, because that is where the fun lies for me. You know, it is different for everyone. Maybe there are people who enjoy career mode, but I simply do not enjoy career mode. I do own a Need for Speed Heat as well, and I really liked its career mode, and I only played that game for career mode, and I don't even touch multiplayer on Need for Speed at this point. So here in this paragraph I also stated that they talk about upgrades. So here it is on the next upgrade, paragraph, it says, you'll notice I mentioned car upgrades. This is something Project Cars has been sorely missing, and it's great to see it finally making an appearance. Previously we've been able to customize the car's performance, but now we can radically change it with new engine, exhaust, suspension. So customization, I am okay with putting on new wheels and liveries and these kind of things, but giving changes such as new engine, exhaust and suspension, I don't know, I really support it, because like I said, I like more sim racing, and in sim world or in real world there is a balance of power that enables every single car on the grid to be on the same level, rather than one car having a V12 engine over 1000 horsepower and the other car is having a V6 with 500 horsepower. That does not create a fair competition if there's a element of this, that everybody is running a highest power to ratio, power to weight ratio possible, you know. So I don't know if I would like to do these things on my car, whereas I really support having a balance of power, BOP on, and that every car, whether it's McLaren, Lambo, Ferrari, whatever, are on the same level in terms of power and whatever is there, and a little bit different in the driving style depending on the person who drives it. So this is the one part I disagree with at this point. So what else? So this is that this means that you can take your like a GT86 all the way to the top. I don't know what they mean by like making a GT3 car out of it. I have no idea what does this mean. We need to see when more info comes in. So here is one thing that I really agree about multiplayer, is that multiplayer has been a big part of Project Cars. Like I said, it's a simulator, so everybody wants to race with each other and have amazing moments, you know, having battles and wins and league races and whatnot. So what they did is in this new game that they have like quick play, which is understandable, and using a skill-based matchmaking, which is already there in Project Cars 2, you can create a lobby according to the licenses. But one thing that I liked is that they have scheduled event mode, which will feature races handcrafted by the developer. So it is more like GT Sport over here. I don't know whether it'll be daily race or 3-day race or a weekly race. So I think this is a really good addition to the game, and this can bring a lot of people into the game because this is more like GT Sport, and that is one of the things that I really like about GT Sport, having a daily race or a weekly race scheduled by developers, and it creates a lot of fun. So this is one thing I agree with. So next paragraph says, slightly mad is also promising improved stability and latency when playing online. Thankfully, I think this is also good, because in Project Cars 2, we had a lot of connection problems and issues, and people would be coming in and they would just get disconnected, or if the host disconnects, the whole, and there will be a you know, host to host what do you call stability of the session, that if one host goes, then the next one can continue and picking up the lobby. But that would create this lag in between that could literally take you by surprise and destroy your pace, and you might end up in a barrier. So I don't know if this thing will be improved in it. I'm sure it'll be better this time. So I think these two things I really like about this. And what else? So in this paragraph, there is nothing special. There are rivals that which has its own unique ranking and reward system, and they have also daily events like here challenges, and also climb the leaderboard, blah blah blah, which is a typical racing game thing over here. So nothing special over here, to be honest. What else is there? There are two new tracks which we saw in the trailer. So this was there are some things in this article that I agree with, and there are some that I do not agree with, such as giving too much importance to the career, because if it was a sim racer, career mode is always bad in sim racing, I think, in my opinion. Because like I said, it is targeted towards more casual players, so I guess it's better. So now I have another article from GameStar.de, which is a German website. I live in Germany, so I got this one. So it is, how do I say, this article is proving the point that I made in my previous video. I specifically said that this game is not targeted towards the sim racing community, towards the hardcore fans of sim racing or project cars and all other simulators out there. I said that this game is more targeted towards Forza crowd, GT Sport crowd and Grid crowd, and I stayed correct over here. It says Project Car 3 has a different plan than its predecessor. Instead of distinguishing itself from the genre top dog, Forza Motorsport, it wants to steal the king's crown, and that requires a rethink. So it proves my point completely right. I made that video before any article came out, and just by looking at the trailer, I was sure that this game will not be a simulator. So over here we can say that this world of racing game is currently dominated by a few giants such as Assetto Corsa Racing, swing the scepter in the realm of hardcore simulations, while specialist games such as Dirt and F1 triumph in their own disciplines, and in the mainstream arcade, Forza Horizon have been competing for years. Where does Project Car 3 want to attack, and to what extent? So here it is. Over here, it is saying that Project Cars 1 and 2 were cross-border commuters, so that means PC and console gamers were all in one place and they were racing with each other. But it is, of course, very hard to have a fair game, because PC version of the game and the console version are a little bit different from each other. And here is, we can say that, and that's why Project Car 3 has a clear goal to beat Forza Motorsport. The gap is there because Forza 8 has been around since 2019, same as GT Sport. And at the latest, but GT Sport has been here since 2018, I think, but also dangerous because the balancing act between hardcore fans and mainstream newcomers has to work. What count now is the right measure. So there it is, guys. It clearly states that the developers are targeting towards the crowd which is more oriented towards Forza rather than GT Sport. It was my bad that I compared this game, PC 3, to GT Sport, because it is more arcade than simulator, the PC 3. So here is another article from the same site, GameStar. It says, it talks about what does the game offer. As we can read over, Project Car 3 should finally conquer the mainstream and take advantage of Forza Motorsport's absence. But ironically, the gameplay changes the least. So let's see what it says. The Project Car developer have been fighting for their piece of the cake since 2015. I think that's when the PC1 came, and had to make noticeable adjustments, readjustments. Project Cars 1 is a great simulation kit, but doesn't take amateurs by the hand enough. Project Car 2 has a great weather simulator, but still kills the amateur with its possibilities. So here it is, completely pointing out that Project Cars 1 and 2 are not user friendly, are not amateur friendly, and not beginner friendly. Actually, in my opinion, Project Cars 2 is the hardest simulator out there at the moment, in my opinion, and it has the best engine in a simulator, with especially its weather. I mean, we get puddles, we get fog, we get snow. I mean, That is the best engine. I love that engine. And if this engine is carried to Project Cars 3, I think it will be a great, great, great addition to the game. And that can also bring a lot of players to the game. So here it is. Over here, there's a typo over here. The hardcore enthusiasts don't care, but the developers obviously do. Over here is also a typo. The new Project Cars 3 is much more targeted at beginners. Here it is, like I said in my previous video. So much so that our 20-minute gameplay demonstration with the developers is almost entirely about how you want to keep people going with the new cars, upgrades, unlock, and more. So it becomes more like an RPG, like Need for Speed, but on track, you know. So let's go here. The fact that one of the best racing games in recent years could roar under the hood is more indicated than stated. I don't know what that means, but don't worry, you have us for that. We clarify how Project Cars 3 even Jenner King. I don't know. I think it has a lot of typos over here, or maybe the translation doesn't make sense because it was in German. So here it is. It tells us what makes it special: new routes, new career, new progression, new challenge. What is the performance index rating, new multiplayer, new technology. Who is it interesting? Here it is. Project Cars 3 wants to win over beginners again without scaring off veterans. Newcomers get an improved gamepad operation, the guided career mode, various hardness settings, driving aids, AI aggressiveness, and so on, similar to Forza Motorsport 7. Project Cars 3 could be the perfect first foray into the world of sophisticated racing sims without having to deal with the bulk of real hardcore simulation. I would say that it will create a lot of buzz around casual racers, but I really doubt that veterans might end up buying this game. Maybe a lot of YouTube sim racers will make a video on this. They will definitely gonna do gameplay videos of this game, and they might exaggerate that how cool is it is, and that might create a lot of buzz among sim community. But I really doubt like hardcore veterans of PC2 will buy this game, because like I said in my previous video, if this game comes around ACC consoles release date, this game will not sell well, in my opinion, among sim racers. This game will sell very good among casual racers, no doubt about that. But among simulated sim racers, this game will not sell good if it comes around ACC. So here it says that Project Cars veterans still get their racing kits and all the weather and simulation options that their predecessor already offers. So that means they are gonna add the same engine with probably better advanced madness engine in terms of weather over here. So the question here is rather whether the new routes and vehicles offer enough variety to justify the purchase. We cannot assess that at the moment, but the screenshot give at least a first impression. So here it is. Like I said, these articles are telling us again and again that the target audience is not sim, it is more Forza and begin and a casual racer or arcade racer. So here it is. It has a lot of Project Cars strengths and weaknesses, all that stuff. So this is my take on it. Like I said, I got a lot of good comments on my previous video. They gave me a very good idea of what people think about this game, because like I said, it is gonna create a lot of buzz among casual racers. I think this game will sell better among them, and it might be a success for Slightly Mad Studios, for Codemasters, but for veterans, for sim community, it's a big blow in my opinion. I mean, I've seen the gameplay, the game looks good, but I don't know. I'm really skeptical at this point. I don't know if I want to buy it. I might not buy it, because right now I'm really invested in ACC and I love that game, and I'm just not feeling intention to buy this at this point. I don't know. Like I said, it is just very, very confusing at the moment for me. I'm sure many people in the same community, the huge fan base of PC2 is confused right now that what is going to happen with this with this game. Like I said, I think that because Project Cars 1 and Project Cars 2 had a really rough start, and Project Cars 2 have been plagued with internet connection problems and force feedback problems, this might be a good idea for Slightly Mad Studio. Because if you guys do not know, Slightly Mad Studios were the one who created Shift 1 and Shift 2, and I remember back in the day when these games came out, I played them, I bought them on day one, and at that point I had no idea what is sim racing. I had no idea there was such a thing called iRacing and all these kind of things. I was a complete arcade racer, and the only reason I bought it because I thought it was cool that NFS is going on the track, and I really enjoyed those games. But I think it is in the DNA of Slightly Mad Studios having this arcade feel, and I think they can do a good job with it. But to be honest, I would not call it a Project Cars 3. It should not have been called Project Cars 3. It should have been called something else, which is more targeted towards the beginner audience, and then they should have released Project Cars 3 sometime after, and that would have been more for simulated people. So now, if let's say now that this game is coming out which is more arcadey, that means Project Cars 4 might be the same. It'll be very hard for Slightly Mad Studios or Codemasters to go back to really ultra realistic hardcore simulation of Project Cars 2 from Project Cars 3, because if this game sells well, they will never go back, in my opinion. So guys, what do you guys think? Please let me know in the comment section below, and I will definitely love to hear your thoughts. Thank you if you are returning subscriber, and I want to thank everyone who has subscribed to my channel. And if you're new, please don't forget to like, subscribe and comment. Please look at my previous video and leave your thoughts over there as well. My name is Yuvi, and I'll see you in the next one.